We're joined now by the student who took that viral photo that put the school in the headlines, 15-year-old Hannah Waters. Hannah, thanks so much for joining us. You're a sophomore at North Paulding High School, and we just learned your school is shutting down on Monday and Tuesday to disinfect after reporting 9 new coronavirus cases. What's your reaction?
I've heard from many friends that they've been getting tests, or that their family members or that their teacher has gotten tested, because it hasn't been safe over these few days. And we were only in school for 3 days. And the fact that we already have 9 cases just at the end of that week is very concerning, because even then we don't know how many people those 9 people came in contact with and how many people aren't taking tests yet, so they don't know, and then they come back possibly this week too, so it just is going to spread like wildfire in that school.
Yeah, and you were sounding the alarm several days ago. Do you think the school would have done this if your photo hadn't gone viral?
I think it would have been later on in the year when they would have addressed what's happening, when more cases started circulating in the school, but I think it would have kind of gone under people's radar for a while until people started posting videos and pictures about it.
I heard you speaking with my colleague Laura Coates a few nights ago. You said that posting this was good and necessary trouble, an homage to Congressman John Lewis. You were punished for calling attention to this. You were suspended, and then the principal, as I understand it, reversed that decision. School officials, as you heard from Natasha there, they were still defending reopening, but we won't even know if the school's going to reopen Wednesday. What's your message now to administrators?
We could have just delayed opening like many other schools in many other counties, because most of them I've heard from friends that are opening on September 8th or around that time. So we could have delayed school so they could find more safety measures to follow in the school, and they could have found more plans for all the students and teachers and staff members. But they kind of just sent us into school and used us as guinea pigs to see what would happen later on.
Guinea pigs. I heard you mention that a lot of your friends and some teachers are getting tested for COVID-19. Have any of your friends expressed concerns or fears about going back to school right now?
We're all pretty concerned about going back, and I know a lot of my teachers are too, because we all want to go to in-person. I have no intention of shutting the county down, the state down, because I know a lot of people don't learn well online. I don't learn well online, and I want to be able to go to in-person school. I want to be able to have some type of normality this year for my semester, but we can't if we're not safe.
Now, the administrators have said that your picture is not fully in context. They're saying that students are actually transitioning classes, a process that takes 5 to 10 minutes, so the chances of exposure actually aren't that high, but do you buy that?
Exposure is like very high in the hallways because we're all smushed together, and yes, it's only 5 minutes to get to class, but there's barely any people wearing masks, and we're all smushed together. There's people trying to talk to their friends, and we're all coming from different classrooms, so the transmission rate is very high in that hallway.
Yeah, what set this whole thing off is that you took this photo and posted it to social media. Pretty normal thing for a kid your age to do. You got suspended, the school lifting your suspension. Remind me, what reasons exactly did they give you?
They didn't give us any reason why they had lifted the suspension. They mostly just apologized and said that they did delete it, but they gave no reasoning behind why they lifted it.
Are you concerned at all that now that you've posted this, you're on national news, that maybe teachers and other students might look at you as a troublemaker, as somebody who is out to start a ruckus?
I feel like a lot of teachers have my back because they know how dangerous it is going to school, but I know that a lot of the kids I go to school with, I've already gotten backlash for it. I've gotten threats and things like that, but I know that I'm doing the right thing, and it's not going to stop me from continuing doing it, but it is concerning, especially since it's a lot of the people I go to school with, people I've known for years now, that are threatening me now.
Hannah, if you don't mind, tell me about these threats. What are people saying?
There's a group chat that a lot of people, that the senior class in North Paulding has, and I think almost all the seniors are in it, and a lot of them have been screenshotting things and sending them to either my family or some of my friends, and they send it to us. And some of the things are like, we're going to jump every girl named Hannah in the 10th grade, or Hannah's going to have a rough day at school on Monday, or someone even said, I know where this girl lives because he lives in my neighborhood. So just not, they're not entirely like something to worry about, but we do try to take them seriously.
But it's still, I mean, that's saying you know where somebody lives in that manner. There's an insinuation there. Why do you think that is? I mean, when I was in high school, if somebody did something that gave you days off from school, usually they were congratulated, but these kids are angry at you.
I feel like a lot of it comes from the seniors, which is understandable because last year, our seniors last semester, that a lot of their senior year was taken away from them.
I see.
But it's happening again this year, so hopefully it doesn't. I don't want it to. I've never wanted it to, but they think it is, and they are trying to blame it on me, which I don't make the final decision at county office. I'm just trying to keep everyone safe.
Yeah, and what's your message to those students?
I just hope that sooner or later, everyone can understand that I'm not trying to shut it down. And when I did, quote unquote, expose Paulding County, it wasn't to cancel the senior year. It's not to go after anyone. It was just to keep us all safe, because you wouldn't have your senior year, because sooner or later the school was going to shut down. And if we shut down or just go online for a week earlier, we can contain it quicker and we can use the rest of your senior year, the rest of the school year, normally.
Yeah, there's also a toll that comes with coronavirus, the cost of life, and I think that far outweighs the cost of losing prom. Nevertheless, Hannah, you mentioned that a lot of teachers have your back. What are they saying to you?
A lot of them haven't really said anything directly to me, but we've heard people like saying that they have my back, or they have messaged or posted some things like, this is the right thing to do. And even though they can't really say much because they work for the county, I do have a feeling from a lot of teachers that they know I'm doing the right thing.
And how about your parents? How do they feel about all of this?
They've been telling me for a while now that they're proud of me, and I've been doing the right thing.
Yeah, you certainly have. Hannah, thank you so much for your time. Appreciate what you've done, and, you know, keep fighting the good fight. Thanks again, Hannah.
Thank you.